Welcome to LabMiz.com in a lab video series on Palo Alto Firewall. This is Metha, your instructor for this video series. For a complete list of our Palo Alto videos, you can visit our website under the Security section. There you can also sign up for our newsletters to receive the latest video updates. Welcome back to another Lab Minutes video series, but this time it is not going to be Cisco. Sorry guys, but you can't deny the gaining popularity of the Palo Alto in the recent years, especially their firewall products that you may almost always come across these days in many networks. So here we are with our first non-Cisco video series. If you are watching this video, then you probably have very little to no knowledge of the Palo Alto firewall and want to learn more about it. Because I have a lot of Cisco firewall background, and I know that many of you are the same way, what we are going to try to do throughout this video series is to compare it back to some of the Cisco technologies, whether they are Cisco ASA, the Firepower, or the FTD from the configuration standpoint. If you already have some knowledge of the Cisco next-gen firewall, you will learn the Palo Alto in no time, as many concepts that you already know about Cisco next-gen firewall can immediately be applied here. Alright, so hopefully I have convinced you enough to watch the rest of this video series, so without further ado, let's get started. In this video, we are going to bring up brand new Palo Alto firewalls and bootstraps and basic config, and we are going to do this from both the GUI and the CLI. At the end of the video, we will wrap up with some certificate install. Here's the diagram for our lab setup. We have two Palo Alto firewalls. One is called HQ Firewall 1, which is acting more of an internet edge firewall that has three interfaces. On the inside, E1/2 connect to the core switch. On the outside, we have E1/1 connect to the internet gateway, and the management interface also connect to the inside core switch. On the VLAN 10, right, with the IP address 192.16.10.0/24, and the management IP is going to be 250. Right, on the core switch, we have a server VLAN, VLAN 32, with a subnet 172.16.32.0/24. On that subnet, we have got our Windows 2012 domain controller. And later on, we use this as DNS server and certificate authority server as well. On that same VLAN, we have our HQ Firewall 2 that's being shown as having a management interface connected. Although it is not inserted in the traffic path right now, but for the intended purposes of this video, it's good enough because all we're going to do here is to put in some basic config so we have remote access to it. So the first thing that you need to know when you take a brand new Palo Alto firewall out of the box is that pretty much all Palo Alto firewall comes with a dedicated management port, and the default interface IP address of that is 192.168.1.1. We are going to start by looking at our first firewall that we have here, which is our internet firewall, HQ Firewall 1, and that model is PA220. So a PA220 is a cool little box that is perfect for either home or lab use. It does not cost much, and you can do pretty much everything that a bigger box can do without breaking your bank. And when I say it doesn't cost much, I guess it's a relative term compared to what could be a much more expensive, bigger firewall. So the firewall has gone through a factory reset, and we can treat this firewall right here as a fresh out of the box. While you may connect your computer directly to the firewall management port and access it that way, here we already have the firewall management port wired up to our core switch, like I said, on the VLAN 10. So what I did was I connect one of the interface on our Windows 2012 on that same VLAN, VLAN 10, right? And I've also given it the IP address on the same subnet. I believe it's 192.168.1.2, right? So they should have no problem communicate. What we're going to do now is to jump into our Windows 2012. I already have the RDP session open. Let me show you the interface that I have maybe. I have a few interfaces on this host right here, and I believe it's this interface that's called ACI out of band that I use in the past video series. I just happened to use that interface without renaming it and connect it to the VLAN 10. Now you can see I have given myself or the server IP address of 192.168.1.2. Okay, so based on that interface, it should sit on the same subnet, and we should be able to access HTTPS 192.168.1.1. Enter. Here we are being presented with the certificate warning because it's a self-sign by default on the Palo box, and the browser is not trusting it. Proceed with the website. There you go. We are seeing the Palo Alto Network firewall lock-in page.